Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Pradwalit Shikha, and in today's video, we are going to discuss about two very important angles, the knowledge of which is very helpful in satellite communication. But before we begin our discussion, let us review some of the very important terms which will help us understand more about these two angles. Now, this is the diagram of Earth. Earth is a sphere. So let us imagine a sphere. This is the center of the Earth. This is the satellite. And let us assume that this satellite is in a geostationary orbit. It can be in a geosynchronous orbit or in any other orbit. But for the sake of simplicity, we have assumed that this satellite is in a geostationary orbit. This point represents the Earth station, which communicates with the satellite from the Earth. So you can see here that we have got three points: C, which is center of the Earth, S, which is the satellite point, and E, which is the Earth station. Now, if we join the points C and S, then this line will intercept the Earth's surface at this point. Now, what this point is? Now, this point is called as sub-satellite point. Now, this is very important because this point actually helps us in determining the longitudes and latitudes of the satellite. Now, you must be wondering, what is latitude, what is longitude? So, we'll discuss that also after completing this discussion. Now let us come back to this. Here S, C and E is a triangle, and in this triangle the side C and E is equal to the radius of the Earth. So I hope this is clear, because the Earth station is on the surface of the Earth. This is center of the Earth. So C, E is equal to the radius of the Earth, which is a constant. Now look at the distance between C and S. The distance between C and S is equal to the orbital radius of the satellite. Since here we have assumed that the satellite is in a geostationary orbit, hence this A suffix GEO, which is the symbol used for this distance, this is equal to the orbital radius of this geostationary satellite. Now, you must keep this in mind that all the orbital radius are calculated from the center of the Earth. Now, only one side is left, which is very important, and which is the distance between Earth station and satellite. So, in this triangle, with the knowledge of this side length, and angle between these two sides, by applying cosine law, we can find out this distance. So the formula that we can use for determining the distance between the Earth station and satellite is root under a square plus r square minus 2ar cos of c. Here c is this angle, c, small c, which is angle between CE and CS. Now we'll see how we can find out the angle C. So as I told you that the latitudes and longitudes can be found of a satellite by using this point, which is sub-satellite point. So let us look at latitudes and longitudes. So this is another diagram. This is the diagram of our Earth. The Earth is divided into various vertical and horizontal lines. These lines are named as longitudes and latitudes of Earth. Now, longitudes and latitudes are very important in determining position on Earth. So, how these lines are marked? These lines are marked in terms of degrees. Let us talk about the vertical lines. The vertical lines start from N and ends at S. N is the north direction, S is the south direction. Here this N is your magnetic north. Similarly, south is magnetic south. This direction is your east direction. This direction is west direction. Here the reference line starting from north to south is called as prime meridian, and which is marked as 0 degree. So this reference line is 0 degree longitude or prime meridian. Now all the lines towards east of prime meridian are all eastern longitudes, and they range from 0 degree to 180 degree towards east. Similarly, towards west, the lines range from 0 degree to 180 degree west. Now, if we talk about latitudes, then the central line which covers the maximum radius of the earth. We know that earth is not perfectly spherical, but it is slightly oblate at the center. So the line which is passing through that bulging part of the earth, that line is the equatorial line, which is 0 degree latitude. So this is this line. That line is also called as equator. All the lines which are above 0 degree latitude are towards north, and they are called as northern latitudes, and they are also marked in degrees. Below this 0 degree equator, we have lines which are called as southern latitudes. Now the range of northern latitudes and southern latitudes are same, and they are extending from 0 degree to 90 degree north and from 0 degree to 90 degree south. So this is the whole division. Now if we have to find out, say for example, I have marked on this diagram two different points A and B, and the longitudes of these points are also marked. So this is 40 degree west, and this is also 40 degree but towards east. Now if we have to find out the angular separation between these two, then what we can do is we can take the longitude towards east minus the longitude towards west. So it is 40 degree east minus 40 degree west. Now what this is going to give to us? Will this be equal to zero? Answer is no. Why? Because there is a sign convention that we follow. If we have to say 40 degree east, it is plus 40 degree. If you have to say 40 degree west, it is minus 40 degree. So all the longitudes which are towards west are negative, and all the longitudes towards east are taken to be positive. So here the difference, angular separation, will be 40 degree east, which is plus 40, minus 40 degree west, which is minus 40. Hence the result will be 80 degree. The same sign convention is followed with respect to latitudes as well. So all the angles or all the latitudes above 0 degree equator are taken to be positive, and all the latitudes below 0 degree are taken to be negative. So hence if we have to say 40 degree latitude towards south, it will be minus 40 degree, and plus 40 degree will indicate 40 degree latitude towards north. So this is the sign convention, and this way the whole earth is divided in terms of longitudes and latitudes. Now we are in a position to define the look angles which we started our discussion with. The two angles are elevation angle and azimuthal angle. Let us first define the elevation angle. For that, look at this diagram. This is the diagram of our earth. This is the center of the earth. This is the earth station, and this is the satellite. This is the local horizontal plane. So the elevation angle is defined as the angle between the local horizontal plane and the line joining the satellite and the earth station. Next is azimuthal angle. Azimuthal angle can be defined using these two diagrams. Here, in first diagram, north, south, east, west directions are drawn, and the center or the cross section of these two lines is the position of Earth station. Now here, this is the satellite. Now if we drop a perpendicular from the satellite onto the horizontal plane, and suppose that plane lies in the southeast direction, and if we join this point to the Earth station point, which is at the center of this coordinate, then this line is called as the projection of satellite on east south plane. Now the angle measured from the north direction with the projection of the satellite on this local horizontal plane is called as the azimuthal angle. So in this diagram, the angle measured from this line, which is towards north in the clockwise direction on the line, which is the projection of satellite on the local horizontal plane. Now look at another scenario. Here the satellite is placed over here with respect to Earth. This is the Earth station. So here the definition is with respect to the Earth station. So this is the Earth station. Now here the line which is perpendicular from the satellite onto the local horizontal plane. So that point lies on the southwestern plane. So let us join this point to the Earth station point. Then this line will give you the projection of satellite onto the local plane, which is in southwest direction. Now the azimuthal angle will be the angle measured from the north direction, this line pointing towards north, in the clockwise direction on the projection of the satellite onto the local plane. So here this is the azimuthal angle. In this case, this is the azimuthal angle. So in different cases, since you have the concept, you can find out what is your azimuthal angle. Now we will look into a problem, and through that problem we will find out the elevation angle, azimuthal angle and range, and we will see what are the formulas for them. The question is, an Earth station at latitude 20 degrees south and longitude 30 degrees west is working into a geostationary satellite situated at longitude 30 degrees east. Then determine the look angles and the range. So here, look angles are the elevation angle and azimuthal angle. And here are the formulas for their calculation. So elevation angle is also represented by symbol capital E suffix L, and this is equal to tan inverse of cos G into cos L minus 0.15 divided by root under 1 minus cos square G into cos square L. And azimuthal angle represented by symbol capital A suffix Z, which is equal to tan inverse of tan of G divided by tan of L. Here G is the longitude difference between satellite and Earth station measured in degrees, and L is latitude of Earth station. Here to calculate range, we just have to calculate small d. So if you remember the diagram where small d is the distance between satellite and Earth station, and this is the formula for it. Here in this formula for angle small c, I have written capital G, and G has the same meaning as C. So let us now see that what quantities do we have and what do we have to calculate. So here we know that capital R represents radius of the Earth, and since the radius is not constant, therefore we take mean radius, which is equal to 6371 kilometers, and then AGEO represents the geostationary orbital radius. This is also constant, and which is equal to 42164 kilometers. So if we substitute these in this equation for range, which is D, and if we substitute for G, which is the longitude difference between satellite and Earth station, we can calculate small d as 9367 kilometers. Now, how do we calculate G and how do we calculate L also? So, first let us see what is G. So, as written here, it is longitude difference between satellite and earth station. So, we will write here G is equal to the satellite longitude minus the earth station longitude. And you have to follow the rule as discussed earlier. So, which is equal to 30 degree east minus 30 degree west as mentioned in the question. And which is equal to 30 degree east is plus 30 degree minus 30 degree west is minus 30 degree. So, this will give the answer as 30 degree plus 30 degree, which is 60 degree. So, we will substitute for G as 60 degree in the formula for calculation of range. And hence, we get this answer. Now, next, what is L? So, L is directly written as the latitude of Earth station, which is given in the question, which is equal to 20 degree south. But again, the sign convention, 20 degree south means minus 20 degree. So, we will substitute L as minus 20 degree in the respective formula. So, if we would substitute all the values for G, 60 degree, and for L, minus 20 degree, then we will get the result as 19.8 degrees. And similarly, for azimuthal angle, we have to substitute G as 60 degree, L as minus 20 degree, and this will give the answer as minus 78.11 degree. Now here, what is the meaning of plus 78 and minus 78? As I told you that azimuthal angle is always measured in clockwise direction from the north direction. But if it is not measured in clockwise direction, it has been measured in another direction, then this angle will be negative. So this negative symbol only indicates the direction of measurement of the angle. So hence, I think you have understood the concept of look angles and you also understood how to calculate different parameters based on different formulas. I hope the video is useful for you. Thank you for watching.